Hi there. We are here with the Monarch Sanctuary Project and our mascot, Lexi, short for Danaeus plexippus, which is Latin for monarch caterpillar. We are here today to teach you a little bit about germinating Texas native milkweeds. Those monarchs, no matter which way you cut it, whether they're going north or south, they have to come through the Texas funnel is what we call it. So I feel like as Texans, it is our responsibility to offer those monarchs what they need to finish their migration, whether that be native milkweeds, nectars, sun, shelter, no pesticides. When we think about germinating milkweeds, we think about what happens naturally in nature. Right, Lexi? So when the seed pods open up, the seeds fall to the ground and they're exposed to rains, winds, colder temps, animals stomping on them. And these natural processes are basically what we consider scarification and cold stratification. In order to germinate our milkweed seedlings, here are the materials you'll need to get started. Today, we're gonna use a green milkweed, common name green milkweed, Latin name Asclepias viridis. Now, green milkweed specifically does require a scarification process, which, as we mentioned, is like when animals will stomp on the seeds to break down the outer casing of the seed. So I'm gonna show you how to scarify your seeds. So we're gonna go ahead and take a jar of a little bit of sand. And I have already included the green milkweed seeds in this jar. And these have already been pre-shaken, so I'm not gonna go for like a rock star workout here. But all the seeds are shaken up. From here, you'll go ahead and pour your seeds into a strainer over a container to catch the seeds. Shake it out, sift it out, and all you're left with is the seeds. We're gonna wanna soak our milkweed seeds for 6 to 8 hours, all the way up to overnight. The rest of the materials for the cold stratification are equal parts perlite and vermiculite. Perlite will help with the aeration. Vermiculite's gonna help a little bit with maintaining the moisture. So we take a Ziploc baggie, make sure it's got a nice little zip on it, and also make sure you label the baggie with what species of milkweed you're using and what date you started your process. We're going to cold stratify our seeds in the refrigerator for 4 to 6 weeks. We're gonna go ahead and pour our equal parts in perlite, voila, vermiculite, voila, and then we will add our pre-soaked seeds into the mix. We're gonna want the mixture to be moist, but not soggy. So what we'll do is we'll add a little bit of water in there. We'll kind of smoosh it around in there. And then we'll take a look at the corners and see if there's water pooling in the corners of our baggies. And then you're gonna throw this mixture into the refrigerator for 4 to 6 weeks. In order for these seeds to germinate, they're gonna need to be between 65 and 80 degrees under bright indirect light. We use grow lights. We also use a seedling heat mat. This is a 10 by 20 seedling heat mat. Pretty soon, you'll start seeing germination from the seed. So the little roots will come out of one end of the seed. I like to use a clear shallow container so that I can see what's happening with the root development on the side. And my germination container has ventilation holes. You can just poke holes into a container if you don't have one with a fancy little knob here. On the bottom, I have placed a layer of well-draining soil mixture. And then we also put a handful of mycorrhizal powder in there. Mycorrhizal powder is a type of fungi that helps develop a connection, like a wheeler and dealer of nutrients with the milkweed taproot systems. Then we're going to spread out our 4 to 6 week refrigerated cold stratification scarified mixture. We'll finish this off with a light dusting of the same germination mixture, just enough to cover the seeds. Once you start to see the first leaves pop out, those aren't actually your true leaves. You're gonna wait for the second set of leaves to come out, and that's what we call our true leaves. Once your true leaves have developed, get your 4-inch pot container ready to go. I like to use a chopstick for my transplanting. So what I do is I put a nice hole in my 4-inch pot. And then once my seedling is ready, I will lift delicately the root systems out and gently transplant it into the 4-inch pot, cover those little root babies up, and these plants will be ready to transplant in the spring or fall.